And here we go with Cinderella Derby.
Noodle, noodle, jamming in the poor CQS. But it looks like who immediately calls it off.
Does not want to race.
As we go through, I'll explain the game a little bit. Each team is currently building a jammer, trying to make through the pack of blockers. We'll always know the jammer because they're the ones with stars on their heads. Taylor Dacto is pushing through the front door.
Also known as T-Dax. And we have, I believe, 404. Chaos fighting away for CQS.
This is the lead jammer. You can tell which one they are because their jammer points at them the whole time. Points. Every time they pass an opposing blocker, they pick up 1 point. You get past the whole pack, that is 4 points total.
Now, there are lots of ways that you can be sent to the penalty box. A lot of them involve ways that you hit another player. Either you hit them in a place you cannot hit them, or you hit them with a body part that you cannot hit them with. There's many rules around those two things. The other really popular one is a cut track. That is when you go off the track and you get back on in front of a skater, bettering your position from before you went off the track. That is a very popular one for jammers, but blockers can get it as well. I'm not sure what SFE's been going to the box for, but they just had a very full box a second ago.
If you want to keep it simple, stay inside the white lines. Simple to say.
Before that final whistle. So we are starting back at 0-0.
After that jam, SFE is on top, 8-4. Anaconda chasing Michelada. Michelada is lead jammer.
Both those jammers finding that same hole and just skating right out together.
Michelada hits back and immediately calls it.
Kaiju jamming for SFV and Scarlett Bronte jamming for CQS. And my timer here would really like to announce.
Go for it.
Black Swan Amazon getting lead jammer for SFV. Chaos coming out of that pack after what appeared to be some additional chaos happening.
Official timeout. Next on Amazon, lead jammer SFB. Number 98, Michelotta in pursuit. Both jammers free to pass. Both jammers going to look to score this next pass.
The pack's going to keep it moving, so the jammers got to chase him a little bit there. Left hand that trap. She was busy coaching.
Going in this jam, it is 21-12. All right, for the Rush Albums. 21-12 SFP on top.
It's an excellent one.
They don't really have bad ones. They're not, yes.
Good old Nuno looking to pick up some points for CPS.
22-15, SFP on top.
Taking that inside line to sweep through and be your lead jammer. I know that's chaos in the back there jamming for CQS, getting stuck behind a wall. SFB doing their best to try to keep that jammer from their pivot, but they eventually got that pass in and the star was passed. Just taking that lead jammer style pretty quick after that first whistle.
And Kaiju making it through the pack for SFB.
Cycles back to the back.
Just enough time for Black Swan Amazon to get lead jammer.
CQS.
Bermuda lead jammer.
La Dominita picking, doing a nice hit to Dana Conda on the outside line there, recycling her back.
See, that was bout shout, pal. It's like a mushroom.
Yeah, I was gonna say, Mario. Have you made that joke before, or are we just thinking this?
I don't think we have.
Okay, because that's exactly what I was going for.
I usually black out when I'm announcing.
So we just bought a car.
Valid. Good excuse.
Yeah, I'm in the middle of that myself right now.
We have Chaos online for CQS and Kaiju jamming for SFV. Both jammers facing some pretty fierce walls here. Blasting through that wall and PAX to be your lead jammer for CQS. Little Fin Sandy was your jammer until there was a star pass to Princess Leia, who is now your jammer for SFV. Amazon is your lead jammer. Brutal Needle is way behind. It was almost a repeat.
Casey Cajones is the nuts. Love Hassel.
Pterodactyl sliding on through that pack to be your lead jammer. Chaos quickly ditching some sunglasses, keeps fighting through that wall.
42-35, SFV up by 7 going into this jam.
Yeah, that math is like down by 3.
First of three if you count any things that break out. If you have to party with Blue Brothers. Score, SFV 50, CQS 35.
And we have a star pass completed for CQS to Cam Reaper. Exploding through that pack to be the lead jammer. Kaiju still fighting her way through.
Yeah! That's the jam. Bad shout to Melly Carey. F him up. Love you. I'm 58-39.
up by 19 points. Both jammers mixing it up. Both jammers not finding the opening they need. Oh, the pass. And a star pass now on the SF inside of these. Star pass SFE to Princess Leia.
That is your lead jammer for SFV.
Pterodactyl working around the track. And that's the jam.
Like, I can put on the Valerie a little higher. Chaos just blasting through that pack right off the line to be your lead jammer for CQS. Janaconda just now making it through that pack as Chaos re-enters looking for points.
Kind of getting knocked down, coming back around.
That was La Danita with that excellent hit to Danny Khan on the outside.
Chaos coming around for points. And there's the car off. Make that 70 points, SFP. 19 points spread.
Bronte fighting and becoming the lead jammer for CQS. Kaiju in the back of the pack fighting for SFE, towing that line. Pittsburgh crushing Kaiju's dreams of getting out of this pack, recycling her all the way back. Big jam for CQS. We'll give you a score update.
And that long whistle does signify the half, so we're going to take a little break. And away we go. Number 709, Brutal Noodle out front, lead jammer. Little open slammy, jamming press FB.
And start passing to May Marmalade Mayhem. We have Black Swan Amazon on the line for SFV and Chaos on the line for CQS.
Black Swan Amazon on the inside. Flips a little bit of the inside track. That was number 8, Dazzling with the hit. And that's the jam.
We have Scarlet Bronte on the line for CQS and Pterodactyl on the line for SFV. Scarlet Bronte is your lead jammer. Dudak taking a big hit to the inside, recycling back. Scarlet Bronte ending that jam.
To the outside, recycles back around. And we've got our first lead change of the game. CQS at 79, 7 over SFB at 72. Go close game.
To be your lead jammer for SFV. Chaos just now making it out of that pack.
It's gonna make like a kaiju stomping through a city joke or something.
Instead of gonna tell us what the joke you could make instead of making it.
Jam there. 3 more points, SFB. Trick, go easy on the cherries. Bex.
There was a larger span of points between these two jams, but just 4 points at a time. We have pecked away at those to be back to a very tight game. Brutal Noodle fighting the SFB line in the front. With Little Orphan Slammy fighting her way in the back. This is the hardest jammers have had to fight before any lead status.
And Gunner sporting the start-up for SFB, Jessen Ez. I read them like they're written. That's not true. I edit them all the time.
I felt like that one was fine.
We have Chaos back online for CQS against Black Swan Amazon for SFV. Chaos
with a back block, it looks like. Yeah. We're going to do a power jam for Black Swan Amazon. Black Swan Amazon officially lead jam right now.
We now have a reverse power jam. Black Swan Amazon is now going to the box for a cut track. As I said earlier, that is when a skater is hit off the track and re-enters the track in a better position than when they exited. For example, getting on in front of the skater who hits them out.
Frank, I wasn't paying attention. Was Chaos already out of the box?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep, Chaos was already out of the box.
So both jammers have served, or will serve, 30-second penalties.
Yep.
However, if the second jammer gets a penalty, and when they get to the box, the other jammer's still sitting there. The first jammer goes up, and the second...
But we are very thankful all of you are here live and in person.
We are. But if you miss the next one, we'll probably be streaming it.
Sky Bronte is your lead jammer for CQS. Exploding through that pack with Kaiju close behind. Jammer on jammer right here.
I had to double check. Yeah, it's right, Richard.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Good job.
I know I had the league right, but then I had the team right. I did.
So I had to pause and feed the child by me. That would be when you make contact with a skater on the other team going in the wrong direction.
And Danica calls it.
Which is still quite a small point margin.
Yep.
CQS has come from behind more than that already this game.
And they've taken the lead already.
Yep.
Kaiju jamming for SFD, and this bounce house for Kaiju. Water sucks, Gatorade is better. The FDA has not evaluated that statement.
I must have missed that last second jammer penalty on CQS as we have started on a power jam. Almost 34 seconds gets that lead jammer status. Just before Chaos can enter that pack from the box. during a jam, they cannot be rejammer. However,
and we've got team timeout being called by SFE.
Give out my private medical history to the crowd too. That's fine.
Oh, you've said it on mic. If I had to lawyer this, I think I'd kill myself.
Third after all being chased by Michelada.
Some good chasing. Ooh, some jammer on jammer action. Jammers are the only skaters who can hit anyone anywhere on the track that they want to. There is no engagement zone. Blockers have to hit within the engagement zone, which is where the pack is, but jammers can hit anyone anywhere. I'm hearing a lot of penalties. Looks like one on either side. It's nice when penalties are, when you lose one on either side.
Good thing for sure.
Yes.
SFE will be highlighting the heritage of many of our league members throughout the month. So check out our Instagram and other social medias to see that.
Perfect, thank you. And we have Blackstone Amazon as your lead jammer for SFE. Poodle Noodle, about half a track length behind.
Heard, we're going to call the winner the 50-50 raffle at the end of this game. So if you want in on that sweet, sweet cash, get a ticket from Peaches. Peaches is the one walking around with tickets above her head.
Danny Conda, despite having a very depleted pack of offense, defense there, managed to sweep through at the beginning there and get lead jammer status.
Got a team timeout being called. This timeout is brought to you by every Olympics. There's like one sport.
Assume it's a big country.
We actually had, I think, a pretty good women's rugby team at my college. Therefore,
yeah. Yeah, I was a banana slug. We weren't really known for our athletics.
I mean, neither were we. No football team to speak of.
Yeah, no football. I've never gone to football. Yeah! Never went to football school.
Kaiju is your lead jammer for this jam. Scarlet Bronte also now out of the pack.
Based on the last bout chat about Kaiju, I don't know if she loves water or Gatorade through the pack, which is what a Kaiju would naturally do.
That's true. I believe Kaiju had a rampage a little bit just to get out of the pack there. There was a bit of a fight there at the beginning. Black Swan Amazon fighting a depleted CQS pack, although still very effective pair of blockers. Boodle Noodle headed to the box, creating a power jam situation for SFV.
Vocalization from the SFP bench.
Yeah!
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 And drag over there.
Status for CQS. pterodactyl fighting through for SFV, manages to pass that star off to Marmalade Mayhem, who is now your jammer, now that that star is on their head.
And then Pterodactyl getting hit there on Chaos, but believes headed to the box, but definitely slowed down. Where's Melly?
Both jammers ended up on the floor there momentarily. Both up, and everyone's good. Fighting some tough rolls here. Both depleted by one, which is probably why we're not seeing as much offense here. Nicolata is your lead jammer for CQS. Danny Conda almost out of that pack, then Hitzberg comes in, takes her out, but does get a penalty for it.
Just under 5 minutes left. SFB 123. CQS now over the Century Market 101. 22 points separating these teams.
Jammer action. Scarabonte hit Amazon off the track and then was trying to take her all the way back, which was a little bit of a standoff there.
This is often done to throw the jammer and going backwards and eating up time for a penalty for one of your own players, which that absolutely accomplished.
It definitely did eat up some time, yep. Absolutely. The one who went there.
Now we fell into the trap.
We're supposed to be working together here. We're supposed to be setting traps.
No chances. And looks like we're gonna race back to the pack.
We don't utilize your lead jammer, but Daddy Longlegs is using those long legs to catch up.
Just over 2.5 minutes left to play. Getting down to those last couple jams. SFB 123, CQS 108 points.
So with Kaiju jamming for SFB against Chaos for CQS.
Michelada for CQS.
A little bit of a no-pack situation there. That pack got spread out a bit. In a no-pack situation, blockers have to stop engaging and let that jammer through. It's like right there, that was a lot of last-minute blocking action from Pittsburgh against Daddy Longlegs.
Yeah. now, folks, I do believe this is going to be the final jam, if the clock is correct.
Looks like a back block penalty.
Means that is the bow. Ooh, a final score for you momentarily. A lot of points changing sides during that last jam, so I want to make sure we get it right before we say it. We're looking for grab this round of tickets because we're about to call the 50-50. Final score, CTS, 108 points, SFB, 131 points. Let's give it up for both teams.